This block diagram represents a numerically controlled oscillator, which is used to generate a digital sine wave with a variable frequency. The main components of an NCO are the frequency control word, the phase accumulator, and the CORDIC IP. The FCW is an input value that controls the frequency of the generated sine wave. To increase the frequency of the sine wave, increase the FCW. For a slower sine wave, decrease the FCW. The phase accumulator is the core of the NCO. It accumulates the phase by adding the FCW to its current value on every clock cycle. The output of the phase accumulator represents the current phase of the sine wave. This phase value continuously increases, and when it reaches pi, the accumulator resets it to minus pi. The phase accumulator generates a phase ramp signal with values ranging from minus pi to pi. The step increment of this phase is determined by the FCW. The CORDIC block converts the input phase into the corresponding sine and cosine values. Phase accumulator and FCW block are implemented as VHDL modules. You can easily download them from GitHub and add them to your design. The CORDIC block in Vivado generates a 32-bit output, where the upper 16 bits represent the sine values and the lower 16 bits represent the cosine values. To access these values separately, two slices are used to extract the respective portions. Download the two VHDL files from the GitHub repository and add them as new sources to your project. Next, right-click on the block design and add the FCW and phase accumulator as modules to your design. From the IP catalog, add a CORDIC IP block to the design. Modify the CORDIC output functionality to generate sine and cosine values. With all the modules and the IP block in place, connect them properly. To run the simulation, you can simply add a clock signal. Additionally, include two slices in the design. The first slice extracts bits 31 to 16 as the sine output. The second slice extracts bits 15 to 0 as the cosine output. Add some ports to the design. It makes the simulation results observing much easier. Finally, create a top-level wrapper and run the simulation. The simulation results validate our methodology. When the FCW value is larger, the phase changes faster, resulting in a sine wave with a higher frequency. Conversely, a smaller FCW value produces smoother phase changes, generating a sine wave with a lower frequency. Let's double-check the zero crossing points of the sine and cosine waves. We can observe a 90-degree phase difference between the two curves. Also, note that the CORDIC block has an internal processing delay, which results in a phase offset between the zero crossing point of the phase input and the generated waveforms. Vivado synthesis and implementation. The FCW and phase generator blocks are fully synthesizable, so there's no need to modify them. However, you must provide a clock source for the design. You can use any clock source, such as the PSBL clock from the Zinc IP block or an external clock generated using the clocking wizard. If you choose to use the Zinc IP block, ensure that the Zinc IP is properly initialized. Otherwise, the PL side will not receive a clock. For example, you can run a simple hello world program on one of the ARM cores, which will activate the clock for the PL side. To keep the process straightforward and avoid using Vitis, I selected to use an external clock available on the ZCU104 board. We need to include an ILA in the design to monitor and study the targeted signals. To ensure enough samples are available in the debugging window, it's a good idea to increase the buffer size of the ILA. All right, we can now proceed and generate the bitstream. After running the bitstream on device, we should be able to see the same results as simulation. Debugging with the ILA confirms the simulation results. As you can see in ILA dashboard, the frequency of the generated waves varies according to the FCW values. I have a challenge for you. Try replacing the FCW module with an AXI GPIO and use the ARM core to control the frequency dynamically.